Do you need 10-bit video recording in your camera? Will you even notice the difference between an 8-bit and 10-bit video footage? Let's have a look at some tests we've done and see if video recording in 10-bit is really worth it. Hi, I'm Jakub from MPB, and I'm going to test if recording in 10-bit is worth the additional cost, storage space, and the computing power. More and more cameras these days allow for recording in 10-bit compared to 8-bit, which is still a very popular way to capture video. For this test, I'm using two Sony cameras, the FX3, which is filming me right now, and my trusty Sony A7 III, which can capture video only in 8-bit. But first, let's explain what is the difference between an 8-bit and 10-bit video.
As you may already know, digital image is composed out of three separate color channels: red, green, and blue. Therefore, the color model is called RGB. Combined together, they create the final image. 8-bit means that each channel can capture 256 shades of a particular color, meaning the final image can display 16.7 million colors in total. A 10-bit file can record 1,024 shades per channel, resulting in over 1 billion colors in total.
Please bear in mind that most of the video content we watch is still displayed only in 8-bit. So what you're watching right now is in fact an 8-bit video. But don't worry, I will demonstrate everything you need to see to make up your minds on the issue of 10-bit video recording. Let's move on to our first test.
Let's have a look at this shot of a garage I passed on my way to work. I recorded the same shot in 4K 8-bit on a Sony A7 III and in 4K 10-bit on a Sony FX3. I shot it with the picture profile turned off, which means the footage doesn't really require any grading before publishing. As you can see, the raw files look almost identical. Even after applying quite a ridiculous color grade, there is not much of a difference between them. Let's try and change the color of the car to make it green. Now, if we go into the mask view, we can see the differences are still rather minor.
Our next test is quite a demanding scenario for every video codec, as there are fine details and smooth gradients in the shot.
This time I recorded a static shot of a tree. It was recorded in an S-Log3 picture profile, which gives me the most flexibility in editing, but requires to be graded before publishing. Now we are starting to see the advantages of 10-bit recording. Look at those ugly edges which appeared on the 8-bit footage. It shows there is just not enough color data to maintain the smooth transition between the sky and the leaves. Again, let's see what happens when I apply an extreme color grade to break the codec. See how the banding in the sky gets more visible on the 8-bit footage. As a side note, look at how this grade revealed a really weird pattern on a shot recorded in the all-intra codec on a Sony FX3.
But we don't film static shots of cars and trees very often, right? Let's film some people and see how the files perform in a more real-life scenario.
For this one, I filmed Jamil, our social and community manager, in front of a blue wall. To make the test even harder for the cameras, I used a Black Pro mist filter to soften up the image and make the highlights bloom. First thing I noticed is that the footage from the Sony A7 III appears to be much brighter, even though it was shot with the same settings on both cameras. After matching the shots, we can see the differences between the codecs. First of all, there are severe artifacts around the neon sign on the 8-bit footage, which are not present on the 10-bit one. Also, the noise and banding on the wall is much worse on the 8-bit shot, and the footage lacks the color data required to render smooth tonal transitions on Jamil's skin. If we go into X-ray mode and have a look at separate color channels, it reveals how much more color data there is on the 10-bit footage, especially in the red and blue channels.
And now, the most demanding test for every video codec, a green screen footage.
This time, I filmed myself in front of a green screen holding this beautiful Fujifilm X100T. It's not the best lit green screen, which was intentional to make the test more demanding. Again, the footage from the A7 III appears to be brighter and I had to correct it in post. The quality of the key is not that bad on the 8-bit shot, but we can definitely still see the same issues, for example on my skin, which we saw in the previous test. There are visible blotches and artifacts where a smooth tonal transition was supposed to be.
One of the downsides of recording in 10-bit is that the files require significantly more computing power. So make sure your machine is able to cope with editing 10-bit footage. If you are a content creator, you'll probably not need 10-bit video recording in most cases. But if you film in a flat or log profile on your camera and do a lot of heavy color grading or visual effects work like chroma keying, 10-bit is definitely for you. If you create videos, for example for YouTube, don't shoot in a log profile, require fast turnarounds, and you want to save up on some storage space, then 8-bit capture is definitely still a good option for you. Don't forget to like and subscribe to MPB's channel and see you in the next video.